It was $500 above and now moved $5,000, now completely withdrawn. Now, surprisingly, RBI said that authorized dealers can devise their mechanism to ensure that A1 payments are happening without A1 form, as good as they are taking all A1 information. That's a different issue. When a payment is happening between one SEZ to another SEZ within the country in a forex, which is permitted, they are now asking us to give A2 form, because in A2 form, one description talks about import of goods between one SEZ to another SEZ, deemed exports concept they are bringing in. I said, for import of goods, why are you talking about A2 form? A2 per se, what defined under RBI is other than goods. Any remittances I do today, other than goods, I only use only A2 form. That's a practice. This is import of goods by an SEZ from an SEZ. It's called a deemed exports, but in their terminology, they are asking us to give an A2 form along with other bill of entry and whatever it is. I am surprised. I have told them, please approach RBI for a clarification. Today, they have blocked all my payments just because we raised this question. We need a clarification for RBI. Is it right on the part of authorized dealers demanding a payment by an SEZ to another SEZ for import of goods A2 form? Which is a harassment, I can tell you that. I mean, we give, because we need to move the transaction. That's a different issue, but would it be required is the question. So we would appreciate these two questions.
We'll look into this.
Good afternoon, everyone. We have come to the end of the interactive session of this day, a full day seminar on FDI. I thank the dignitary on the dais to make time and accept our invitation to come and address the queries of all the professionals here. I'm sure all the professionals have made the best advantage of having the regulatories here and getting the queries clarified. And we have witnessed here too how RBI is friendly with the professionals. Thank you very much, sir, and thank you very much, madam, to facilitate this. And we would look forward for more sessions on this, like this, and I'm sure RBI would facilitate that. On the other side, looking at the response from the members and the chapter, we promise that the chapter and the members would volunteer for any program for creating awareness on PREMA. So we would promise this, so that we can collaborate and create awareness on PREMA. So you can take that liberty to ask us, so we can anytime collaborate for that. Thank you very much. Now I would request CS Mahadev Prakash to come forward and present a memento to Mr. Sudhanshu Prasad. CS Jairam to come forward and present a memento to Ms. Usha R. Rao. Thank you, sir. And now I request CS Milind to come forward and present a memento to Mr. Kailas. Compile all the questions and hand it over to the RBI officials. Now we will break for lunch.